Japanese street whiz brands have come along only to disappear after a short-lived run. But Supreme has remained as consistent as they can while continuously expanding its reach. It was founded in 1994 by James Jabaya with a startup budget of $12,000.
James Jabaya isn't the greatest leader of a company. He has been sued multiple times over ethics issues, but he still gets the job done.
Which industry that has most influential label in streetwear? In 2017, its net worth was recorded at $40 million. Despite its obvious potential, Supreme chose to limit itself to 10 stores worldwide. As far as New York, LA, London, Paris, and Japan, although its fan base has grown beyond just skaters, Supreme's maintained the brand aesthetic and representation.
As CEO of Supreme, James Jabaya has made a conscious effort to keep information about himself and Supreme as much under the radar as he can. His reasoning for this is that he wants the product Supreme releases to speak for themselves. Since he rarely provides interviews, there is no information on whether Jabaya or Supreme as a company donate to charities, or how exactly things are financed and what the figures are. In regards to cultural norms though, Jabaya has made it essential that Supreme continues to stay rooted in New York's skate culture, despite becoming an international company. The culture norms of New York skating are what makes Supreme, Supreme. The company stays tied with the New York culture by collaborating with New York's greatest artists, musicians, and sport teams.
In an era where longevity is scarce, Supreme has managed to hold the crowd as one of the most coveted brands in the game. While physical growth has been intentionally slow, if Supreme continues to reach more people at the rate it's been reaching them, it will be harder to maintain the brand as exclusive and authentic. As long as Supreme can keep control of their image through their apparel, they should have a few more years to come as the biggest name in streetwear.
The influence of the skateboard brand is evidenced by their frequent collaborations with some of the biggest names in the retail world, such as Nike, Louis Vuitton, and the North Face. One of the most popularly noted reasons for the brand's success is their super limited supply drops. The limited supply drops create exclusivity and competition among buyers to get pieces from the release and drive up insane demand. As buyers compete for limited pieces, an entire culture or cult has formed around buying Supreme clothing. People wait in lines for hours to days depending on the drop, or join online chat groups to look for certain pieces being resold.
There are other aspects of Supreme's business model that have brought it to where it is today, one of them being its relationship to music. There are a few other brands that have taken inspiration from music history more than Supreme. Since its founding, Supreme has created numerous proper tributes to music's most influential artists. In regards to hip-hop, some of the Supreme's best collaborations and tributes have been with Raekwon. Watch these rap niggas get all up in your guts. Prince Vanilla, Butter Pecan, Chocolate Deluxe. Even Caramel Sundaes is getting touched. N.W.A. With the Mac-10 on the side of my hip, bailed outside and pointed my weapon. Just as I thought, the fools kept stepping. Jumped in the foe, hit the juice on my ride. I got front and back and side to side. R.Z.A. Wu-Tang forever. Wu-Tang forever, Wu-Tang forever. The resurrect in your sector. From Shaolin to the holy city of Mecca. Yo, assassination, vaccination, poor education, infatuation with Satan. Dipset. Yeah, Dipset. Come on. Yeah. With your boy. Yeah. It's Santana. Once again. Hey, man. Oh, yeah, man. Let me see you do this. Kill him. Public Enemy. What I want you all to do for me. Bang! Caught you looking for the same thing. It's a new thing. Check out this I bring. Uh-oh, the road below the level, cause I'm living low next to the base. Come on! Turn up the radio. And 3-6 Mafia. Yeah!
For the first time, it's going down history, baby. New 3-6 Mafia. Featuring A-Ball, Nymph, JG, Young Buck.
The designs in these collaborations are inspired and always informed by a knowledge and passion for the history. In recent years, Supreme have been one of the hottest clothing line in hip-hop with artists like Kanye West, Drake, A$AP Rocky, and Nas all supporting their collective pieces. These artists most often wear Supreme tributes to hip-hop artists that preceded them,
This then creates a positive feedback loop for Supreme. As the brand continues to pay homage to hip-hop legacies, current celebrities will continue to wear Supreme and build its hype to other consumers.
Does anyone know how SupremeMe is always using other people's work? To my knowledge, a lot, especially their early clothing was all unlicensed, but they have only received a few legal repercussions that I am aware of. Some of SupremeMe's products are licensed, normally shown on the tag or through various meanings. Sometimes SupremeMe happens to sample or borrow from artists without permission, but it is usually more of a parody. There have been multiple instances where they had legal trouble. Barbara Kruger, Candy T, and Louis Vuitton, their limited runs helped them avoid a lot of legal issues. Usually when a company's logo are being used by another brand, they have to file a cease and desist before filing lawsuit for damage. But if all the products are sold before the C&D can be afforded, then it's kind of considered a moot point. C&D go out pretty regularly, especially to streetwear company, but usually the logo in question is changed enough to fall under parody, and most companies like to avoid unnecessary litigation. So in most cases, they are usually okay with an agreement to not sell any more of the offending product. They did have to follow through and destroy products bad when they parodied the Louis Vuitton Morrigan style, which is why that stuff is valued much higher than other stuff from their era.